Hello, so we are working on infarct core segmentation for patients suffering acute ischemic stroke. And ischemic stroke is one of the deadliest diseases worldwide. It's a major cause for permanent disability. So ischemic stroke happens when a part of an artery in your brain is obstructed by, for example, blood clot. This leads to a reduced flow of oxygen in the brain and can lead to cell death. So the size of this infarct core is an important biomarker to determine what kind of treatment we have to do in the hospital. So to assess the size, we make a CT perfusion scan. And a CT perfusion scan is a four-dimensional 3D plus time scan of the brain, where we actually observe the flow of blood in the brain. Through CT perfusion analysis software, we can map this four-dimensional image to a series of three-dimensional spatial maps, which tell us something about the perfusion of blood in each part of the brain. Now, classical infarct core assessment is based on thresholding these parameter maps, which is a pretty basic approach. A lot of deep learning models have been developed to perform this task of infarct core segmentation from these parameter maps. For example, in the IELTS 2018 Medical Imaging Challenge. But in practice, there's a lot of difference between the CTP analysis software packages. So these parameter maps are different depending on which software package you use. So this is why we want to perform direct infarct core segmentation from raw CTP data, so we can achieve an infarct core assessment independent of the vendor's CTP software. So others have tried this as well, and it has been shown that it's typically less effective. And we think this is because it's difficult to capture the spatial temporal correlations in CTP data. But because of the sequential nature of our data, and with the current popularity of the state-of-the-art sequential models, the transformer, we wanted to investigate if we can use these transformers to capture the spatial temporal correlations in our CTP data. So we split our method into two parts. First, we have a transformer model which encodes the spatial temporal correlations into a spatial attention map. Thereafter, we have a UNet, which takes the spatial attention map, the first frame of the CTP sequence, and the frame at maximum intensity as an input to perform final infarct core segmentation. I will not go into too much details on their transformer model, but I want to show that we follow the architecture of the original vision transformer VIT very closely. Whereas VIT actually takes a 2D image as the input and splits each image into a series of patches, we extract a patch and we use the subsequent frames as our series. We also extract a patch at the contralateral side of the brain as an input to the transformer to exploit the contralateral side at the same time. So the goal of this transformer is to determine whether the central four pixels of this 32 by 32 patch are infarcted or not. We then apply our transformer to the CTP sequence and we achieve our spatial attention map. We extract the first frame and the frame at maximum intensity. And for both of these, we also use the symmetric flipped representation of this image as the input to the UNet to exploit the contralateral side at the same time. Using these five inputs, we can perform infarct core segmentation, and I show a result here where we actually observe a very nice overlap between our result and the ground truth. So our transformer model achieves a top dive score of 0.42, which is a 10% increase on the test data set using for all the methods using only CTP source data. Now, I must stress that we only compare to the methods that only use CTP source data, because we do not yet meet the results of the models that use the spatial maps from the CTP analysis software. So our transformer yields this spatial attention map, which we can easily interpret and could be valuable in a clinical setting. And our method provides a primary benchmark for the application of transformers to spatial temporal CT perfusion data. Well, now the architecture of our transformer is still pretty basic, and we follow VIT very closely. So there are still lots of room to improve this architecture, and we will do so in the future. So if you have any questions, please drop by our poster or feel free to ask them in the live sessions. Thank you.